Older models of our nitrogen plastic welding system, like this first generation 6056, have been known to melt at the handle if allowed to overheat. Fortunately, damage such as this can be easily repaired by shop technicians, eliminating the need for expensive repair returns. To perform this repair, you'll need a 6150H replacement handle, and, depending on the scale of your damage, a 6062ME replacement element and a 6175 barrel in that assembly. Make sure your welder is disconnected from power before you begin the repair. Cut the hose beneath the melted handle and remove. Measure the length of the new handle against the hose, as you will be feeding the wiring through the length of the handle later. Use a razor knife to score the rubber hose, taking care not to cut too deep. Pull and remove the hose, then repeat the process on the wire housing underneath. Once the three wires are exposed, slide on the pinch clamp, followed by the new handle. Apply the red and blue fittings. The red go onto the black and white wires, while the blue goes onto the green ground wire. Crimp tightly. Connect the couplings to the element socket as you see here. It does not matter which pins the black and white wires are attached to, as long as the green ground wire is attached to the flat pin as you see here. Feed the socket and wiring into the handle, making sure to line up the screw holes. You might have to apply some pressure in order to get the socket snapped into the handle. Apply the screws and fit the hose around the bottom of the handle. You may need to apply lubricant. Tighten and pinch the clamp around the base of the handle and the hose. Finally, snap the heating element in place and then reapply the barrel and nut. Look to Polyvance for all of your plastic repair product and training needs. We offer ICAR Industry Training Alliance courses as well as other hands-on classes in addition to the video resources you can find on our website and on our YouTube channel.